Hello, hi, welcome to this video. This is Arvind Mota. So we'll talk about the market view and trade setup for the second week of October 2020. So as you can see in the Nifty daily chart, Nifty was consolidating just below the 20-day moving average between 11,200 to 280, which was acting as a strong resistance zone. But on Thursday, we took out that 20 moving average with a gap up, backed by good positive global cues, and right now Nifty is closed above the 20-day moving average, which is acting as a strong support. So as long as Nifty is staying above 11,318, I think we can still go up further. So any kind of dip towards support will be a buying opportunity. So on the downside, 11,287 is the level which I'll watch out for. Any kind of breakdown below, I would look at closing my long positions and shifting to creating shorts. But shorts you can avoid unless Nifty breaks down below 11,140 zones. This gap may get filled. So between these range, that is 11,140 to 11,287, I'll stay cautious. It'll be a range bound trend, but that will happen only if Nifty breaks the 20 moving average. Right now, it has shown a very good recovery after this huge fall. And the next level on the upside, if it sustains above this support, I'm expecting Nifty to test 11,502 followed by 11,604. These are the two levels I'm looking at Nifty to test in the coming week with support here. So, any kind of dip will give me a good buying opportunity with very good risk to reward ratio, very minimal risk, stop loss somewhere here, and good reward ratio. So I'm staying long in Nifty as per this chart. Right now, coming to the Nifty internals, you can see even though Nifty opened gap up, it was able to sustain this and it closed almost near the high point of the day, that is 11,422. Which is a good sign. There was no buying, I mean, there was no selling pressure throughout the day, and Nifty is holding after the gap up. That is a good sign. So this momentum can be expected to sustain on the upside, and that's why I'm staying long. So coming to Bank Nifty. Okay, Bank Nifty also recovered from this big fall. And this is forming a good classic trend reversal pattern, bearish pattern followed by a spinning top and then a good bullish candle, right? It is also closed above the 20 moving average, which is a positive. So we can stay long in Bank Nifty, but one factor we have to consider is it is going to reach the congestion zone between, you can see here, 200 to 300 points. This is a congestion zone where Bank Nifty spent almost 1 week's time here. So this will be a strong resistance zone in the near term. It will be a tough zone to cross. Bank Nifty can consolidate here, or it may even come off the highs a little before taking a second attempt to cross over this. But once it takes out this level of, say, 400, 500, then we can expect another uptrend, right? So as of now, I'm in terms of index, I would prefer to trade in Nifty than in Bank Nifty, because Bank Nifty has already rallied after this gap up. It has rallied almost 4%, right? 3.7%. So I would not expect another big rally in Bank Nifty, even though we have a, the Supreme Court verdict is expected on interest case. But the result is almost known to everyone that, so it's already been priced in, based on the rally that we saw on Thursday. So I'm going to stay a little cautious on Bank Nifty. So that is my view. Now coming to Bank Nifty internals, also you can see here, almost same like Nifty, gapped up and stayed above right through the day. So it is definitely showing strength, and a few of the stocks in banking sector, we can definitely look for buying opportunities. Any kind of dip here will still be buying opportunities. Now coming to global markets, as you can see here, US markets actually tanked on Friday after the US president tested positive for COVID-19. But there was a very strong recovery towards the end of the day. So both Dow Jones and S&P showed good recovery, and they've actually regained most of the losses. Europe trend is kind of mixed, so nothing much to read there. And Looking at the FII data, after many days of selling in cash market FIIs, you can see throughout they were selling for almost more than a week, almost 10 days. And right now you can see there was very good buying from FII. So if this trend is continuing, definitely we can expect more upside in the market. Now coming to SGX Nifty, it is also holding 20 moving average and it is closed almost near 11,400. That is a good sign. You can see internals, it actually fell almost to 11,300 on Thursday, Friday, but it's shown very good recovery. So if we totally open here and sustain, I think there is more upside left. Again, this will act as a strong support, 11,300 levels. So we can expect further upside here. That is on the index. Now coming to stock specific view, few of the stocks which I'm having in my watch list is Pidilite. Pidilite is actually can see very good trend reversal pattern, bearish followed by a doji and a good bullish pattern, right? And it is also closed above 220-day moving average, and I think we can expect levels of 1485 to 1510 range. The drop in prices in crude oil may also work in favor of the paints stocks. And similarly, I'm also having Berger Paints in my watch list. You can see Berger Paints also has given a good rally from here, supported 20-day moving average. Again, it tested that, and right now it is forming like a dragonfly doji. But I would look for buying opportunities only if it takes out 594, 595. If it sustains above, we can expect higher uptrend. 600, 620 can be expected. But let's see if it's crossing out this level of 595. I can look for fresh buying opportunities. So another stock I'm having in watch list is Bajaj Finance. Okay, you can see Bajaj Finance also has closed above 20 and 200-day moving average. Beautiful move on Thursday after 2 days of consolidation, and I think there is more upside left in Bajaj Finance. In terms of targets, I'm having 3557 followed by 3607 and 3713 on the upside. The three target levels of stop loss just below the 200-day moving average, around 3278. So we can go long here. Another stock is PEL. The Piramal Enterprises also has given a good recovery from the lows and is close above 20 and 200 moving average. In fact, I already gave a buy call on this and we booked some profits. But I think there is more upside left in this. In terms of targets, we can expect 1350, 1379, stop loss just below 200 moving average, around say 1260 range. So we can go long in PEL. Another stock is Axis Bank. Axis Bank, also ICICI Bank, both these look good. Axis Bank is reaching a congestion zone, almost same like Bank Nifty. You can see here 450 around thereabouts. So if it clears this 452, 453 and stays above, I will look for fresh buying opportunities for targets of say 480. First target can be around 475, followed by say 488, 499. But if it has to close above this and sustain, that will give me fresh buying opportunities. And another stock is TCS. So TCS, you can see it is just moving up, very strong uptrend, forming higher highs and higher lows. And if I see a move about say 25, 30, 25, 40, we can definitely go long in TCS. We can expect higher levels and fresh all-time highs. And the results expected next week, the quarterly results, I think that may, if it is positive, we can expect further upside momentum, right? That's on TCS. So these are the stocks which I'm having in my watch list. I've given my view on the market index as well. Now coming to last week's trades, I'll just show you a few of my trades and my clients' trades. This was on Thursday. One of my clients was able to book good profits. We took a trade in IndusInd Bank, gave an amazing rally. We took a 540 call option. Nifty also on Thursday, it gave a good breakout in the 15 minutes chart. So we took these trades, and this was an IndusInd Bank. Tech Mahindra also gave a beautiful rally from 800 to 823. PEL, I told you in that call, that worked well. IndusInd Bank, this Bank Nifty also, we took a call option that worked well. That was my client's trade. And few of my analysis, ICICI Bank also, you can see here, it looks good to test 382. I'd given a buy call on this. And Titan, okay, that's one of the trades which we analyzed. DMart also, Britannia worked well for us. And this was a trade which we took one of my client's trades. Okay, so these are the trades. Cipla, Dr. Reddy, Pharma was doing well, I think, on Tuesday or Wednesday. So some of the picks which we analyzed. So just for your information. Okay, so that's my view for the next week, and I've shown the trades which we took, and I hope you liked the video. Please subscribe to my channel if you like to receive more updates, and also enable the notifications. And I'll give the links to my coaching programs and support services. If you like to subscribe, you're welcome, and you can also reach out to me through email if you're interested. All right, so take care. Happy trading week ahead. Bye bye.